Welcome back to Flatirons Tuning. For this tech tip, we want to take a look at what the difference is between a dry sump oiling system and an Accusump and where one or the other might be the best fit for you. As we're starting to kind of make more content with putting the dry sump on a race car and figuring that out to get it to work the way we want it to, we're getting more questions about Accusumps and where what they do and where they might be an option compared to a dry sump. So we wanted to make a video just to kind of give you guys a better idea of what an Accusump does and all that. Right at the front, before we jump into it, I just want to say, if you like this channel, if you like the content that we're putting out, please do like the video and subscribe to the channel. That helps us out a ton, and those likes and subscribes go a long way to helping make sure that other people are going to see this content, and that's going to help the channel grow. The other thing I want to say is, if you do like this content that we're putting out, the best way to support us is to head over to flatironstuning.com. If we've got anything there for you from stickers on up, your support at flatironstuning.com goes a long way to helping us be able to come back and make more videos for you. So check out the website, and as always, thank you very much for watching and thank you for your support. Okay, so let's dive into it. In terms of the function of the dry sump, we made a handful of videos about that already, so I'm not going to go into too much detail about how a dry sump works or what it does. But I want to say that there are some key points about a dry sump in the discussion between that and an Accusump. The biggest ones are, with a dry sump, it eliminates the oil pan and the oil pickup. It eliminates the stock oil pump, and it moves the oil pump basically off of the crank, so it's not directly driven by the crank. So you have a lot more control of the oil pump and of the speed. The other thing is, it also eliminates the PCV system. So if you're having issues with any one of those things or multiple parts of those, which is not uncommon on race cars or high horsepower cars, because it eliminates all of those, the dry sump is a big help for that. Two other key things about a dry sump oiling system is, one, most good dry sumps are going to give you very easy access and control of your relief valve pressure. So with the stock oil pump, oftentimes you have to get in there and actually remove the oil pump to do any kind of change to the oil pressure, and you don't have a lot of hands-on ability to do that. Whereas most dry sumps will give you some kind of a spring or a set screw or combination thereof to set that relief valve pressure, so whatever that peak pressure is, so you have a lot more control over that. The other key point is, with a good dry sump system, you have scavenge pumps that are actively pulling oil from the engine, from the crankcase, out into your external tank. So that really is a key piece of the puzzle to help make sure that the oil is always ready to go into the engine and serve its need, versus some of the issues you can run into with a pan, with sloshing and oil servation in corners and so forth. So those are some key things to keep in mind about a dry sump as we're going into this. So what is an Accusump? I will tell you right off the bat, this is not an Accusump. I do not have one on hand, but I realize that this little pool squirter is a great visual to kind of picture what an Accusump does and how it works. A number of years ago, we sat down with Mike at Peterson Fluid Systems to talk about oiling systems, and one of the things we talked about with him was an Accusump. So I would definitely say go back and take a look at that video as well. But for this conversation, we're going to use this to visualize what an Accusump is. So an Accusump is a tube that holds oil, and it has a pressurized air chamber at the back of it. So if this is our Accusump, you pull back the piston, and in the Accusump cylinder, there's going to be 1, 2, or 3 quarts of oil. There's three different sizes of Accusump. And on the other side of that cylinder, on the other side of the oil, is an air chamber, and that is pressurized. So this really is kind of the way that an Accusump works. When the pressure in the engine drops below the pressure in the air chamber, or pressure that's pushing on the oil, the Accusump is going to push that oil in at that pressure as long as there's oil in the cylinder pushing. Now, when whatever the issue was is resolved in the engine, but it caused the pressure to drop and the pressure comes up again, when the pressure in the engine is higher than the pressure in the pressurized chamber in the Accusump, it's going to refill. So that's when the oil is going to move back into the Accusump, and then it's going to be there ready to jump in the next time you need it to. Because it's an air chamber, the more that piston is compressed, the higher the pressure gets. So there's going to be, if your oil pressure is for the most part higher than whatever the setting of the Accusump is, it's going to reach an equilibrium point, and then it's just going to start going back into the engine if the pressure drops below a certain threshold. So if you're looking at an Accusump or a Dry Sump, one of the first things to consider is certainly cost, but also like if you've got a race car, are you allowed to put a Dry Sump on, or are you not allowed to put a Dry Sump on? If you have to keep the stock oiling system or whatnot, a Dry Sump might not be an option. And an Accusump, because it does give you that buffer, is definitely going to be better than nothing. But again, with an Accusump, the key things to remember, your oil pan and pickup are still there, the stock oil pump is still there, and the PCV system is still there. So if you're having issues with any one of those things, you're still going to want to address those issues as best as you can, in addition to putting an Accusump on, if this is the direction you choose to go. So again, as far as what the function is of the Accusump, the other key thing to picture here is the Accusump is only going to send oil into the engine once you kind of reach a floor pressure that is set, so that it can maintain that minimum oil pressure. There's a lot of talk about, or people start to think about, whatever your peak oil pressure is. How much oil pressure can you maintain at wide open throttle at 5, 6, 7,000 RPMs, whatnot? The Accusump can't help with that peak pressure, because again, it has to be the chamber has to be pressurized to whatever pressure you want the oil to be sent into the engine at. If you want to make sure that you're never dropping below 80, or you're maintaining 85 psi of oil pressure at wide open throttle and full boost, an Accusump is not going to help you with that, because you can't set it at 85 psi, because it's going to then push all of that oil into the engine when you're below that, and you're never going to be above that threshold to refill the Accusump, so that it can't be ready there for you when you need it at wide open throttle and full boost. So that's the other key thing to keep in mind with an Accusump. It's there to maintain a floor, a minimum oil pressure, but it really can't do anything about a maximum oil pressure. That's where if you really have to get to that point of control, that's where the Dry Sump is pretty significantly different than the Accusump. But given that buffer and that protection of the minimum oil pressure, an Accusump is definitely better than not having it if you are having problems with oil starvation and no other fixes have resolved it. The other thing worth mentioning with an Accusump is, again, it can only intervene as long as there's an oil volume in the chamber to be sent into the engine. So, for instance, if you have a car where you have an issue in high G corners, and you're on a track where you're going into, say, a set of S turns, if you've got your 3 quarts of oil in the Accusump and it's starting to go in because your pressure has dropped in corner one, and then corner two comes up very quickly and it can't really refill much before you go into corner two, you're going to have less volume to maintain that minimum pressure in corner number two. And if there's a number three quickly thereafter and it can't refill between then, two and three, then you might act, there's always a possibility with an Accusump that you could run out of oil in the chamber to maintain that minimum pressure. So if the Accusump runs out of oil, it can't do anything to help maintain that minimum pressure, and you have to get the pressure above that minimum for long enough to fill up that chamber before the Accusump is really fully ready to step in again to kind of maintain that minimum pressure, whatever that might be. The other thing, in thinking of that, with the sizes of the Accusump, the 1, 2, and 3 quart, if you're driving a Subaru that has, say, a 4.5 quart pan, it would seem like the 3 quart Accusump is a ton of oil to have on hand if you need it. And it kind of is, but the thing you have to consider what you have to look at is not the amount of oil in the pan, it's the volumetric flow rate of the oil pump. How long does it take the pump to flow, say, 3 quarts of oil? That's really the protection that an Accusump might give you in terms of time versus just thinking of it strictly on it from a volumetric standpoint. Now, if you do kind of run out of the Accusump, the optimistic part would be, if you have a 4.5 quart system typically, and you've just added another 3 quarts, now you've got 7.5 quarts somehow in the engine that's waiting to come and be pulled back into the Accusump. So hopefully, if it is a starvation issue in the pan, adding all of that extra oil would hopefully slosh over the pickup, get it fed, and minimize the time you would have that starvation, so that you would hopefully not run into many situations where you're completely depleting the Accusump so that it can't be protected. But it is something that you'd want to consider and want to watch. And in terms of the PCV system, there can be some things that can some issues that can come up if you really dramatically overfill the oil in the crankcase. So if you have some set of issues that is so great that you're moving all of the oil from the Accusump into the engine, this might not be the best solution for you, and you might want to really try and investigate and solve those problems before you put the Accusump on. That's basically what an Accusump is and what it does. And again, if you cannot run a dry sump, if it's just not an option, it's certainly going to be better than nothing. Just have to keep in mind where it excels and where it is somewhat limited. But that's what it does. So hopefully that helps. Hopefully that gives you more information. You're better able to make a choice between these two systems and what might work best for you. So thanks very much for watching. Hopefully you enjoy the video. And as always, stay tuned with Flat Iron's Tune.